to morning prayer on the day of our Lord, Wednesday the 21st of April, and it's me again, Jack here, leading worship today. We are recording from St John Baptist Church in Claines, Worcester, which will be streamed as usual on Facebook and YouTube. I'm going to mention some forthcoming worship services. We are continuing with Zoom at 10:30 throughout May and June, and next week, Easter 3 will be led by Reverend Joe and Reverend Jenny. As we slowly come out of lockdown, we will be offering Holy Communion on alternate weeks at both churches, May the 2nd, 4:30 at St George's, May the 9th, 4:30 at Claines. Please contact the wardens to book a place, check the newsletter, or simply ask someone if you're not sure. Be assured that we are moving forward with hope. I will be using prayers and readings from a variety of resources today, including some daily prayers for the Church of England people and myself. Today is the feast day of St. Anselm, 36th Archbishop of Canterbury and teacher of the faith. I often use a prayer written by him. It can be found in some daily prayers for Church of England people, but of course it's for everyone and it has been adapted. Now let's settle ourselves, be comfortable, take a moment and be still for our opening prayer. Come now, put aside your busyness for a while. Take refuge for a time from your troublesome thoughts. Throw away your cares and let your burdensome worries wait. Take some time off for God. Rest for a while in him. Enter the secret room of your mind. Put out everything except God, and whatever helps you to find him, and it may be your cross, it may be stone, these lovely stones with a cross and hold them. You may like to light a candle. Enter the secret room of your mind, put out everything except God, and whatever helps you to find him, close the door of your mind and seek God. Say now to God with all your heart, I seek your face, Lord, your face I seek. Amen. Last time I talked about St. Patrick because it was his feast day. Today our theme is going to be about St. George, because it is his feast day or special day on Friday of this week, the 23rd of April, and he is our patron saint. The image most familiar to me, and probably to you, is of St. George dressed in a white tunic, bedecked with a red cross, astride his stallion, and skewering a dragon as he rescues a fair maiden. The tale of the dragon is taken from a book called The Golden Legend. It was first translated into English and printed for mass circulation in 1483 by Caxton. George, the Knight of Christ, told the people not to be afraid. Ne doubt ye no thing, without more believe ye in God Jesu Christ, and do ye to be baptized, and I shall slay the dragon. St. George is identified with English ideals of honour, bravery and gallantry, but he wasn't English and is the patron saint of many other countries, including Georgia, Lithuania, Palestine, Portugal, Germany, and Greece. Who was he? He was born in Cappadocia, an area now in Turkey, in the 3rd century. His parents were Christians, and when his father died, he returned with his mother to his native Palestine. George became a soldier in the Roman army and was personal guard to the emperor Diocletian. The emperor began a campaign against Christians. In about 33 AD, George objected to this persecution and resigned his military post in protest. He infuriated the emperor by tearing up the emperor's order against Christians and was inevitably imprisoned and tortured. George refused to deny his faith and was beheaded in Lydda, Palestine, and became, like many in the early church, a martyr. He died for his faith. Myths were created about his martyrdom in the early Middle Ages. But it is important to understand that people at that time would have believed and wanted to believe such stories. It was a mystical time. One such story is that St. George made a miracle appearance in the Crusades, leading them into battle. This is recorded in stone over the south door of a church at Fordington, Dorset, and still exists. When Edward III founded the Order of the Garter, the premier order of knighthood in England, he puts it under St. George's patronage. The magnificent St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle was built by Edward IV and Henry VII as the chapel of the order. And I'm now going to sing a hymn, which is a very old hymn, not used very much these days, but it just fits with what I've been saying, really, about St. George. When a knight won his spurs in the stories of old, he was gentle and brave, he was gallant and bold. With a shield on his arm and a lance in his hand, for God and for valour he rode through the land. No charger have I, and no sword by my side, yet still to adventure and battle I ride. Though back into storyland giants have fled, and the knights are no more, and the dragons are dead. Let faith be my shield, and let joy be my steed, gainst the dragons of anger, the ogres of greed. And let me set free with the sword of my youth from the castle of darkness the power of the truth. Still to adventure. We're all on our own journey of adventure with God, and it's available for all. Last Saturday, many of us will have watched the funeral of the Duke of Edinburgh, which took place at St. George's Chapel, Windsor. It was a deeply moving occasion watching the Queen, isolated, reminiscent of what has happened to many families throughout the year. I began to reflect upon the leadership of the Duke of Edinburgh and of other known Christian leaders, like Aaron Bevan, Martin Luther King, Mother Teresa, Archbishop Desmond Tutu, to name but a few. And we could do with people like them now. The truth is, Jesus was a brilliant leader. And those who have important leadership roles could learn so much from him. Why then? Why can we learn so much from Jesus? Well, Jesus was not self-promoting like many world leaders of today. When he began, he made this clear. He placed himself under the care of John the Baptist, showing that he was going to teach his followers that submission does not mean weakness. Jesus was displaying the first example of what true servant leadership is all about. Jesus' style was simple, clear, and direct, as shown in his teaching and preaching and the use of parables. His parables were more than a story. He told truth through them. Let's see what Jesus has to say. I'm going to read from Matthew, chapter 13. Then the disciples came and asked him, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" "The reason I speak to them in parables is that seeing that they do not perceive, and hearing they do not listen, nor do they understand. With them indeed is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah that says, 'You will indeed listen, but never understand, and you will indeed look, but never perceive. For this people's heart has grown dull, and their ears are hard of hearing, and they have shut their eyes, so that they might not look with their eyes, and listen with their ears, and understand with their heart, and turn, and I would heal them.'" Jesus understood that how to build a team, and he started with men who had something in common. Fishermen, they all had shared values. Then when Jesus had a strong core foundation, he was able to recruit others of differing and diverse character, for example, Matthew the tax collector and Simon the zealot. This way, Jesus showed how it is possible to bring together different people. Jesus was all about empowering others. One thing Jesus did, which we can all do, he practiced daily prayer. There are many examples in the New Testament. And now I'm going to read from St. Mark, chapter 1. In the morning, when it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. For that is what I came out to do." St. Luke says, "Then Jesus told them a parable about their need to pray always and not to lose heart, not to give up." Time for quiet reflection, meditation, prayer is so important in the busyness of life. God comes to us at those times and helps us. Jesus was all about empowering others, releasing the best in us. St. George left us a powerful message. He died for his faith. And sadly, that still happens today. A fundamental part of being human is being willing to bear the cost of what you believe, not to bend to the dictates of fashion, or to please others, or to avoid suffering. Only in this way can we fulfill our destiny and make a lasting contribution to the world. Take courage, my friends, and do not lose heart. And now we're going to have a time for prayer. So let us pray. And I'm going to begin with some words written by Saint Francis of Assisi. You are holy, Lord, the only God, and your deeds are wonderful. You are love, you are wisdom, you are humility, you are endurance. You are rest, you are peace. You are joy and gladness. You are all our riches, you suffice for us. You are beauty, you are gentleness. You are our protector. You are our guardian and defender. You are courage. You are our haven and hope. You are our faith, our great consolation. You are our eternal life, great and wonderful Lord, God Almighty, merciful Saviour. Amen. We remember and praise you for the saints and martyrs of this and every age, whose lives like seeds drop to the ground, yet whose witness has inspired us and borne fruit. Amen. We praise and thank you, Holy Spirit of God, for the women and men you have called to be saints, from your first fallible, frightened friends who followed you to Jerusalem, through the centuries of discovery and growth, people of every class and temperament, down to the present day. We praise you, Holy Spirit, for calling us to serve you now, for baptizing us to represent you in this broken world. Help us to be Christ's united body, to heal and reconcile. Help us to share Christ's life with everyone. Amen. And now let's take a few moments together for your own personal prayers. Share your joys and sorrows with God. Ask for strength and help, and maybe think of others and the world. We will say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now I'm just going to read a collect or special prayer for St. George. God of hosts, who so kindled the flame of love in the heart of your servant George, that he bore witness to the risen Lord by his life and by his death, give us the same faith and power of love, that we who rejoice in his triumphs may come to share with him the fullness of the resurrection, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. blessing as we go our separate ways. But before that, I would like to thank Ian and Rachel for their technical help. Thank you so much. And now to finish, a blessing. The Lord bless us and keep us. May he show his face to us and have mercy. May he turn his countenance to us and give us peace. The Lord bless us all. It has been a pleasure and a privilege to be with you today. Go well and safely. The Lord be ever with you. Amen.